John, what about that? Chris Christie seemed to feed into his own bullying narrative today. Let's take a look at this.
I think you asked me a question the day after the election. Are you willing to change your style in order to appeal to a broader audience? And I think I said no, because I am who I am, but I am not a bully.
I am not a bully.
Or a witch.
Or a crook.
Right. But, you know, the evidence doesn't hold up there. Let's take a look at one more thing that I want you to take a look at.
Did I say on topic? Are you stupid? On topic. Next question.
Yet you have numbnuts like Reed Gashura get the hell off the beach.
Hey, Gail, you know what? First off, it's none of your business. I don't ask you where you send your kids to school. Don't bother me about where I send mine.
Thank you all very much, and I'm sorry for the idiot over there.
You know what? It's people who raise their voices and yell and scream like you that are dividing this country.
That's a fraction of what's out there, of him confronting his own constituents. It doesn't even include him calling a Navy SEAL an idiot, for instance. You helped run Rick Santorum's campaign in Iowa.
Correct.
You were a key aide.
And all the other states he won.
Right. And he won Iowa.
So
how is this going to play in Iowa?
Well, first of all, let me be a little bit more general. And I do a lot of crisis management. I do message training. And I believe Chris Christie knocked it out of the park. He did a couple things that were brilliant. First of all, they didn't make the mistake of trying to rush out something yesterday. They waited for today when they could get the narrative. They knew what the real story was. That's number one. Number two is that they were able to announce they took action. They fired somebody. So it wasn't like we're going to investigate this. He looked decisive. Number three, I think he should get bonus points that he said that he learned about this after doing his workout yesterday. So he's also laying the groundwork that he is becoming physically fit.
Yeah.
With that said, he also does have a reputation as a bully, which is not as negative as people think. Today we did see some humility. He used the word embarrassed. He looked like a real person. But frankly, I will tell you, there are a lot of Republicans that rather have a bully be negotiating with Iran on nuclear power, with negotiating with the Russians on missile defense, than somebody like Obama who's going to whisper in their ear that he's going to be more flexible
after
the election.
You want somebody like this with their finger on the nuclear weapons of this country?
I want someone who can be both a tough guy when he needs to be a tough guy, but like we saw today, he showed humility. He showed that he can also have a heart, and yeah. I thought he came across very likable.
He's got a long way to go before he's negotiating with Russia, but I like your optimism. Governor Richardson, I know Democrats are going to try and hang Chris Christie on this. I don't blame them. He is our top, you know, one of our top contenders for president. But what more do they want? He came out today. He apologized. He spent 2 hours talking and taking questions from all kinds of reporters. He looked patient. He's going to investigate this. Do Democrats run the risk of overreaching on this and looking a little desperate in the process?
Well, look. Let's put this in perspective. This has not been a plus for him.
No.
Even though he might have had a decent day today. Yeah. This is a tarnish on his image. And my confession to you is that of all the Republicans out there, the one I fear the most in 2016 is Christie. So
right.
I'm going to put that on the table. But this has been damaging. You know, the tough guy stuff that John said, I think I agree with John. However, I mean, there are other issues here. Mm-hmm. There's potential illegality here. There's little kids in a
right.
bridge that can't get through. The possibility that vindictiveness, pettiness,
yeah.
that bipartisanship. I mean, I liked it when he and Obama were working together on that huge tragedy in his home state.
Does this discredit that image of
well,
him?
Well, yeah, it hurts that image aisle? Because, yeah. you know, we're talking about a Democratic mayor. Who, by the way, is pretty colorful.
Yeah, he is good TV.
you know, they called him a Serbian. And I think this guy has handled it well. So this is not a plus for him.
Yeah.
And it's not over. So I think what yeah. needs to happen, as Stephanie said, is, you know, this is not ending. He probably had a good day today. But again, in the whole context, yeah. It's hurt his image.
But-